Morning students, welcome to the computer class of 4th standard. Today we will continue with our chapter 4, formatting a document. So open page number 36. Students, previously we have learnt about what is formatting, what are the features of formatting, how to change the font, font size and font type. So today we will do page number 37. And the main objectives of page number 37 are how to apply bold, italic and underline effects and how to change the text alignment. So open page number 37. Before starting our first topic, we will discuss the terms. So our first term is bold, makes the selected text darker. Second is italic, makes the text slanting to its right. Third is underline, places a line under the selected text. Fourth is alignment, position of the text on a page. So now open page number 37. And our first topic is applying bold, italic and underline effects. The font style options such as boldface, italic and underline are used to emphasize the text and catch the reader's attention. Emphasize means to give special importance to the text, and catch the reader's attention means, students, when you will make the document more attractive, it will definitely catch the reader's attention. So now, to understand bold, italic and underline, you can see this figure 4.2, where the word invention is written by using three formatting effects, bold, italic and underline. The first invention word is written darker than the rest, that means we have applied bold effect. Second is italic. A text becomes slanting to its right, that means we have applied italic effect. And third invention is having an underline under it, that means we have applied underline effect. Now, the steps to apply any font style effects are, the first step is select the text. Second is click on the button bold or italic or underline. Students, you can see these IDs of bold, italic or underline also. So now let's do its practical by opening MS Word 2010 window. Our Word window is opened on the screen, and students, you can see that we have already applied three formatting effects like font, font size and font color. So now we will apply the other three formatting effects, bold, italic and underline, which are present in font group. So first of all, to apply the bold effect, you have to select the text by dragging the mouse over the text. So our text is selected. Now click on bold button. You can see now our text becomes more darker. That means we have applied bold effect. Second is italic. Now, to give italic effect, first of all select the text and then click on italic button. You can see now our text becomes slanting to its right. Similarly, to apply the underline effect, we will select our main heading, games, and click on underline button. You can see that our games heading is having an underline. That means we have applied underline effect. Now the second way to apply bold, italic and underline effect is by using the keyboard shortcuts. The shortcut key to make the text bold is Ctrl plus B. To make the text italic, Ctrl plus I. To underline the text, Ctrl plus U. Students, you have to note down these shortcut keys on your copy also. So let's do its practical by opening MS Word 2010 window. Students, you can see that we are having an on-screen keyboard by using which we will apply the bold, italic and underline effects. So first of all, to apply the bold effect, select the text then press Ctrl B key from the keyboard. You can see that our text becomes more darker. Now, to apply italic effect, again select the text and press Ctrl I key from the keyboard. You can see that our text becomes slanting to its right. Now, to give underline to our main heading, first of all select the main heading and then press Ctrl U key from the keyboard. You can see that the game's heading is having an underline. So we are having two ways to apply bold, italic and underline effects. First, by using the keyboard shortcuts, and second, by using the bold, italic and underline buttons from the font group. So now on page number 37, our second topic is changing text alignment. Alignment refers to the positioning of text on a page, means where you want to position your text. For example, you want your text to appear on the left side of the document, or on the right side of the document, or in the center of the document. So it is always better to set the alignment before typing. Students, you can see this figure 4.3, where paragraph group contains four types of alignments. The first is align left, second is center alignment, third is right alignment, and fourth is justify alignment. So now we will do these four types of alignments. First is align left. It places a selected text towards a left margin. By default, the text is aligned to the left margin. So student, this is the by default alignment of the text, which will places the text to the left side of the document. Second is center alignment. It sets the text in the center of the left and right margin. This alignment is mostly used for titles, headings. For example, students, when you are making a project on historical places, then to give heading in the center of the document, first of all you have to select the heading historical places, and then you have to click on the center align button. Now the third is align right. This aligns the selected text towards the right margin. It is often used for placing dates or reference in a document. Students, when you do copy work, you mostly put date on the right side of the copy. Similarly, when you are working in MS Word 2010 and you want to put the date in that document on the right side, then you have to click on the align right button. So it is mostly used for placing dates in a document. Now next is justify alignment. It places the text evenly between the left and right margins. Students, you can see your computer book, it is equally justified from both the sides. So it is mainly used for designing books, magazines and newspaper. So let's do its practical on the screen. You can see, students, the paragraph group contains the four alignment buttons. First one is align left, second is align center, third is align right, and fourth is justify alignment, and which is the by default text alignment, that is align left. Now to perform the center alignment, first of all select the heading and then click on center align. You can see that our heading is shifted in the center of the document. Similarly, to put this date to the right side of the document, first of all select the date and then click on right align button. You can see that our date is shifted to the right side of the document. Now we will do the fourth alignment, that is justify. To perform the justify alignment, first of all select the entire document and then click on justify alignment. You can see that our document is equally justified from both the sides. Now we will do the identification of the icons. First is B is given, that is bold. Second, I is given, that is italic. Third, U is given, that is underline. Now fourth is align left. Students, if we are having the equal lines on the left side, that is align left, and if we are having all side equal lines, that is justify alignment, and if we are having equal lines on the right side, that means align right. And if we are having the equal lines in the center, that means we are having align center. Students, you have to note down these IDs on your copy also. So today we have discussed about how to make text bold, italic and underline by using buttons in font group and keyboard shortcuts, and how to set the alignment left, right, center and justify. Students, further we will discuss in next session. Till then, you have to do reading and practice of the page number 37. Thank you.